Sorry, Mimi.
Oh
Now you have to do it again.
Yeah, gotta play it again, Mimi. Now you're all warmed up.
Well, everybody else can go, and then if we're short of stuff, I'll play it again.
An encore, okay. Encore performance.
Yeah.
Thank you, Jack. I didn't know.
Thank you, Jack. So, Mary Jane, how about if I put up the scan that you sent me? Is that okay?
Well, actually, I've been practicing
the other one?
Yeah, the other one I was able to find and print.
Okay.
And it's the one with all the woo-hoos in it.
Yeah, all right. I've got that one here handy, too.
Oh, you've
got
to have a song with woo-hoos in it.
We want them.
This one's got plenty woo-hoos.
Well, the other one had yodels in it, so that would have been good, too.
Yeah, but... well, my version, I think I learned it originally like this or similar to this, and then I replaced it with yodels because I thought that people would rather hear real yodels than... woo-hoos, but this song is apparently woo-hoos.
Well, I noticed that there is a yodel in it, but there's a bunch
of
woo-hoos
too. A short yodel, yeah. And I just made it into a longer yodel so that people who liked yodels would be satisfied. Some people of that nature in my circle of friends.
All right,
but I'm perfectly happy with this version, you know, everything about it.
Cool. All right. Is it big enough? Can y'all see it?
Yep.
All right. Let her rip.
Okay. From Don Walzer. I had a Don Walzer album and it was on there, and I thought, oh, this is great. And I don't think he did quite as many woo-hoos, so that my arrangement was a little different. But he did the woo-hoos, and then I changed him to yodels. But I'm back to the woo-hoos again.
More woo-hoo.
Y'all want to do Blue Moon?
Sure.
Yeah, I love Blue Moon.
All right. Hello.
Tell me what you're reading.
So I looked this song up because it's got that C, A minor, F, G thing going through it. And I was really curious where that started. In popular music, Blue Moon is the first song to use it, and that was from 1934. But it turns out that Bach and Mozart also used that in pieces, not over and over again, obviously, but they did use it, so it's been around for a long, long time. So, anyway, so C, A minor, F, and G, Blue Moon. We forgot to start it. Thing. Okay, one, two, three.
Blue moon, you saw me standing. Okay.
We got to start over. We didn't start our thing scrolling, so. Okay.
Okay.
One, two, three, four. You saw me standing alone.
Without a dream in my heart, without a love of my own. Blue moon, you knew just what I was there for. You heard me saying a prayer for someone I really could care for. And there suddenly appeared before me the only one my arms will ever hold. I heard somebody whisper, please adore me. And when I looked, the moon had turned to gold. Blue moon, now I'm no longer alone, without a dream in my heart, without a love of my own. And then there suddenly appeared before me the only one my arms will ever hold. I heard somebody whisper, please adore me. And when I looked, the moon had turned to gold. Blue moon, now I'm no longer alone, without a dream in my heart, without a love of my own, without a love of my own.
Very good. Third time's a charm, I guess.
Yes, but anyway.
That was great. Thank you.
Thank you.
Gary, you got a song tonight?
Yeah, I do. I'm going to, even the moon thing, I'm going to do Moon River.
Ah.
Oh, good.
But I'm not going to sing it because I'm playing the notes, and I can't play notes and sing for some reason.
Must be a night for old standards.
Well, it was earlier. We'll see about after this. That's it. 1 minute.
All right. Good job.
It's got some chords. It's got some weird, like a B sharp minor 7 flat 5th in it.
Whoa!
6 fingers to make it.
What key were you in?
Pardon?
What key were you in?
I am in C.
Oh, you were in C.
Yeah. Theoretically.
Yeah, I had the chords in G. A simplified version that didn't have that chord you were talking about.
What's the melody
though? C minor with a finger way over here. My skill set at the moment. I'll get there.
Gary, what's the first note of the melody?
D, and then C.
First one, was it a G, the first one?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Yeah. G. Yeah. Nice.
Cool. Thank you.
And I can send this something with this. I never send you anything, Paul. Sorry.
It's okay.
It's not until the day of I go, oh, I better get something ready.
You can send it to the email list.
Were you reading tabs, Gary?
Those were not notes. It has tabs, but I was reading notes.
That's why I was asking, yeah.
Yeah, thanks to Kevin Carroll, by the way.
Yeah. All right, cool. Jack, you got a song tonight?
Yeah, I have 2 short songs by Gustav Holst. I timed it, it's about 3 minutes, so. I figured I could sneak by with 2. The first song is, I figured in the midst of the bright hot summer, I would play In the Bleak Midwinter, which is, both of these are Gustav Holst, the music is by him. Many people know him as the composer of the Planets. The second song I'll do is a short section from the Planets, but the first one is In the Bleak Midwinter. Give me a second to set up. And this is an arrangement by Colin Tribe. I've played a bunch of his arrangements. Is that too loud? Is that too loud? Okay. Kind of a variation. Thank you. So that was In the Bleak Midwinter. The second song, I have to change ukuleles because I just realized it's in low G, not high G. So this second song is a hymn called Backstead. It's also written by Gustav Holst. It's a hymn that's this melody by Holst has been used in a bunch of different hymns. I counted at least 20. I looked it up on Wikipedia Britannica, and they showed at least 20 hymns. So. Alternate ending. Anyway, thank you.
Good, Jack.
I really like the alternate.
Yeah.
Yeah. Sounds like I need a slide version.
Yeah.
Hey, Walter, you sent me two songs, I think.
Yeah.
Which one do you want to do first?
I got off, actually. I was listening last week to songs that were hits in 1960, and I continued on with that, and I found a copy of, The Twist. Everybody knows The Twist.
Yeah.
And another song by the same author, which is Finger Poppin' Time. I imagine you guys have both heard those. And so I can do either one. Well, it looks like a Finger Poppin' Time is up.
Yep.
So hang on here. All right, here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4. Hey now, it's Finger Poppin' Time. Finger Poppin' Time, I feel so good, and that's a real good sign. Hey now, hey baby, come along with me. Hey baby, come along with me. We're gonna shake it till it breaks, just wait and see. Here comes Mary, here comes Sue, here comes Johnny and Bobby too. It's finger pop, popping time. I feel so good, and that's a real good sign. Hey now, it's finger pop, popping time. Finger popping, popping time. And that's a real good sign. And somebody forgot his kazoo. So excuse me for 1 second. Johnny and Bobby too. It's finger pop, pop. in time. I feel so good, and that's a real good sign. Hey now, hey now, hey now, hey now, it's finger pop, popping time. Finger popping, popping time. I feel so good, and that's a real good sign. I feel so good, and that's a real good sign. It's a very simple song, but it's a lot of fun.
I like that chord progression.
Yeah.
Yeah, I like the D to the C. I don't know why I get a kick out of that going through like a D, dun, 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 dun. You know that C sharp in the middle? That's fun to play. M. Porter, do you want to sing to us about the summertime?
Yeah, well, we've had in the bleak midwinter, you know, and you know, it's time to bring it back to the
hot.
Where we're at. This is.
I hope somebody's doing autumn leaves next.
This is summertime. Summertime, and the living is easy. Fish are jumping, and the cotton is high. Your daddy's rich, and your mama's good looking.
You did well. You played all those chords, and it sounded great.
That's one of my favorite songs. I just really like it.
Steve, you got a song?
Yeah.
Oh, one of these days, Steve's going to say yes.
Well, you know, I've been thinking about my lack of progress. I attribute it to not actually having a plan of learning anything. I just sort of noodle and just play what's familiar. And so what I've been doing is identifying songs that I actually want to be able to sing, and that use chords I already know how to do. And so, yeah, so I have a plan to actually learn a song. So.
Oh, we can't wait.
You don't actually have to sing. You can just play a song without words.
I've done that. I've done some progressions and things before.
Oh, that's true.
I want to actually like sing a song, because I mean, ukuleles were designed for accompaniment, so I should probably do that.
There you go.
Before we go on, I like to sing, and then you can find the chords.
Whatever happened to Rich? Remember he used to come all the time? Did he move, or
He didn't move. He's got some personal thing going on that's interfering with coming to this. I don't know what it is.
Okay, I was just curious if he moved or something. So.
Yeah, no, he's still around, but I don't know what he's really up to.
Great if he came back.
Yeah.
Did he send a message about Kevin?
Yeah.
There was some family thing that was keeping him away.
I think I missed that one.
Well, maybe we could get Mimi's song recorded.
Yeah, Mimi.
Now that everybody's gone.
Yeah, that sounds like a good idea.
Hold on a second.
Let me... I need another meatball.
Hold on.
We get another shot at it.
A meatball night.
Yeah, all right.
It's going to cost us 30 cents, though.
Yeah.
Yeah, well, probably more with inflation, but okay.
All right. Let's hear it. Gonna say the same thing, even better.
It's better the second time.
Just kept, you know, the first is always just you stepping on yourself. Well, yes.
I think it's time.
Oh,
it's all done. One. Let's go get a beverage of our choice and sit back for the Rootorium part of the visit.
All right, I'll be right back.
Second one.
So, I'm So, Paul, can you hear us?
I can.
Oh, okay. So the other week or two ago, you were asking about the blackbird, and then I started to feel as though I was neglecting it.
I noticed you were playing it tonight.
Yeah, I started, you know, I do like it.
You paid big bucks for it. You gotta like it.
I better like it. You're right. Yeah. No, I think I had banished it, and now I. But it's also because it's a concert and it's just the perfect size for me.
So, do you think your favorite ukulele is based on what it sounds like or what it's like to play? Like it's easy to play.
Well, see, I think I can't say that I have a favorite. I have two that I really like. And one is my tenor Kala, and they have different sounds, and sometimes it depends what I'm playing. And also, like for certain things, especially if I'm just, you know, noodling around like solo type thing, I think the tenor is just easier for me to get my fingers moving because, I mean, the concert. Maybe they're a little bit closer together. It just fits my hand better.
Yeah.
But, like, I don't know, some of the tunes we play in the orchestra, I think the tenor sounds better. I feel physically this is more comfortable for me.
Yeah.
So it's, I can't say, you know, I think they're both really nice, but there, I have four ukuleles and those two are my favorites.
And Steve is laughing. Four ukuleles.
Four. Yeah, I mean, four ukuleles.
Yeah, Steve's more like four dozen.
I told Gary after last week I want to go out and buy some more ukuleles.
Yeah, I'm beginning to feel I need to keep up with the Steve.
Good luck.
I'm going to share. I have my list up. I'll share my list with you here.
Oh, cool.
Yeah.
And you can see host disabled participant screen sharing.
Oh, hold on. I'll let you.
Steve, you have a favorite?
Try again, Steve.
Yeah, I do. Let's see here. Share. Okay. So I have them sort of arranged by. You see that?
Yeah.
So I have them arranged by kind of scale. And so the ones that are yellow here are like projects I've picked up. There's something wrong with them that they need to be fixed, and my to-do project list is getting longer. But just this last week, I picked up a dolphin ukulele, a soprano, thinking it was a project, but it actually works just fine. I was quite surprised by it. And then I got a bunch of concerts. This one's on the way. This is the Zerikote one that's on the way, so I'm looking forward to that one. But my tenors. This is my favorite tenor right now. I got this from Mackay. I did a review of it. I borrowed it. And they liked the reviews. So they said, just keep it. I said, fine, I will. It sounds really nice. My two favorites, one is a spruce-topped K-Mies baritone, and then this Mackay spruce top. And the spruce just has a nice sound to it, which I really like. But these are the tenors that I've got. And then the berries. One bass, and then some guitars, and lots of guitar projects.
I see, yeah.
Yeah, two tenor guitars, and then my banjos, so yeah.
Wow.
I haven't added them all up, but as you can see, I have more, I'm waiting to retire so I can do all these projects.
Do you have a room dedicated to these?
I've got a couple of rooms dedicated.
Really big place.
Well, I have an apartment here in Austin. That's where I am now.
Is that just for the ukuleles?
Turn out that way. I have a bedroom here. It's my daughter's apartment, but and so it looks like a hoarder's. I have like ukuleles like lining the walls and hanging up on the walls. And then down in San Antonio, I have a playroom. If you ever watched any of my videos I do, it's usually in that room. And there's a lot of instruments that are like out of view. Yeah, they're really starting to pile up here. My wife thinks we need to get a locker just so I can put them all in. But I'm like, I played them. Like, today, I must have played 6 or 8 of them.
Really?
Like every day, I purposely seek out instruments just to play them. And there's some was like, oh, I really like this one. I can afford to lose this one. So, but ultimately, I mean, I don't want to keep all these. At some point, I want to, like, you know, find a school when schools are ever back in session that are looking for instruments and say, here you go. Here's a half dozen ukuleles or a dozen or whatever. And the guitars that are my projects, I don't want to keep them all. I'm going to, like, rehab them and then give them away.
Yeah.
You know, I would give away an instrument every week on my YouTube channel. Except it costs a fortune to mail stuff these days.
Yeah.
So, yeah, I mailed something, a little stomp box, was like $14 to mail a stomp box. It's crazy.
Yeah. Saw Bob playing the stomp box with the brushes.
Yeah.
In the demo
there.
Oh, you saw him?
Yeah.
Yeah,
I gave that to him just last week.
Okay.
Where was this you saw that?
On the Bob's video for the next Austin Ukulele Society meeting.
Have you seen it already?
That's right. That's Thursday, isn't it?
He put out a note.
It came out today.
Sent the email out.
Okay. The email just came out?
So. Yeah, it was on the website a few days ago.
Yeah, well, back a month or so ago, I made a stomp box and... he liked it, so I said, I'll make you one.
Yeah.
So I made him one, and I finally got around to giving it to him because I was up here in town, and we met last week, and I handed it off to him. And he said he was planning on incorporating that into the video. And I also did a review of a cajon. I gave him the cajon because I didn't really play the cajon. I thought they might use it for the society, so.
Well, the stomp box sounded great in the new video. You should see it if you haven't.
I guess I have to find that link. Was it an email that came out?
It's
on the website.
Oh, I'll go check the website then. Okay. Yeah,
it's great. Also on his Bob's YouTube channel. So if you follow his YouTube channel, it should have notified you.
Yeah, I'm subscribed, but maybe I didn't click notify me. I'll have to go check that.
So I got a song I didn't play yet.
Yeah.
You want to hear it?
Oh, yes.
You could read my mind, love, what a tale my thoughts could tell. Just like an old-time movie about a ghost from a wishing well. In a castle dark or a fortress strong with chains upon my feet, you know that ghost is me. And I will never be set free as long as I'm a ghost that you can't see. If I could read your mind, love, what a tale your thoughts could tell. Just like a paperback novel, the kind that the drugstore sells. When you reach the part where the heartaches come, the hero would be me. But heroes often fail, and you won't read that book again because the ending's just too hard to take. Like a movie star who gets burned in a three-way script. Enter number two, a movie queen to play the scene of bringing all the good things out in me. But for now, love, let's be real. I never thought I could act this way, and I've got to say that I just don't get it. I don't know where we went wrong, but the feeling's gone, and I just can't get it back. If you could read my mind, love, what a tale my thoughts could tell. Just like an old-time movie about a ghost from a wishing well. In a castle dark or a fortress strong, with chains upon my feet, but stories always end. And if you read between the lines, you'll know that I'm just trying to understand the feelings that you lack. I never thought I could feel this way, and I've got to say that I just don't get it. I don't know where we went wrong, but the feeling's gone and I just can't get it back.
That was wonderful.
Excellent.
That was great.
Very nice.
Thank you.
Where'd you get that tablature?
That what?
The tablature for that.
I don't know. The internet.
Can I get it? Love that song.
Yeah, of course. I'll share it when I send out the video links. I'll put a link to this PDF.
I was just this last week. I was watching a video about that. There's a guy has a channel called.
That's exactly why I played it tonight. I saw the What Makes This Song Great, the Rick Beato.
Rick Beato, video. Yeah. Oh, yeah, man. I saw that. I was like, I mean, I remember hearing that as a kid. And I mean, even as a little kid, that song just blew me away.
Yeah. Yeah, his videos are really good. I like the analysis he does. And
oh, yeah.
This is just, all I've got is the chords, and it's just arpeggio through the chords.
Beato.
It's a Gordon Lightfoot song, though, right?
Yes.
Yeah. Got great chord changes.
Yeah. Did you use the same finger picking pattern the whole way through?
Mostly. I just sort of. Yeah, it's like.
When the mood hits you.
Yeah, I change a little bit once in a while, but mostly it's the same all the way through. And the only trick is getting your fingers to go in automatic mode, because the words don't line up with the finger strikes exactly. So there's a little bit of practice to get the finger picking going.
I really like that Rick Beato channel, but he gets so in depth, I get lost.
Yeah, well, his theory videos are. He'll have a theory video. It's like, here's the basic things that everybody should know. And like two sentences in, he's like way beyond where I currently am. So
he did a video last year. I guess he's teaching his daughters how to play the guitar. He says, these are five things that every beginner needs to know.
Right.
That's a useful video.
Did you say it's spelled B-I-O-T-O?
B-E.
Oh, like like the Beatles, B-E-A-T.
Oh.
B-A-T-O. Okay, got it. Thank you.
Rick Beato.
Okay.
Yes.
I just opened up his website, and he's got John Williams versus Gustav Holst. Gustav Holst tonight. And so much John Williams Star Wars, I think, is based on Gustav Holst.
I didn't know that. Oh, yeah, I do know that from that video. I've seen that video. I forgot about that. He compared it to
the planets.
Yeah.
Right. Uh-huh.
Great.
You know, one of these days, I'd like to learn like the Game of Thrones theme. That would be cool.
When Gustav Holst wrote the planets, in his infinite wisdom, he left off Pluto, but this is kind of ominous. He left off Earth.
Oh no!
Only seven planets. So he may know something we don't know.
Yeah.
Held the right one, I guess so.
When was he writing? When?
In the late 19th century. I have his dates. It's 1874 to 1934.
Actually, Pluto hadn't been discovered yet.
Right.
That's right. That's right.
30, yeah.
Yeah.
And technically Pluto isn't a planet, so
not anymore.
Yeah, well, it was deplanetized.
Yeah, it's a planetoid.
That Earth is not going to be deplanetized one of these days.
We defunded Pluto.
We did?
They defunded Pluto.
Well, I was watching something. They were talking about the demise of Earth. They said eventually, you know, when the sun burns up all of its energy, it's going to, you know, expand.
Red giant.
So it actually expands past Earth. Yeah. It's unfortunately, it's about 5 billion years from now, so I think we're probably all right.
Yeah.
We won't be around.
Yeah.
Don't overdo those anti-aging pills.
I guess it depends on which channel you watch. We were watching a channel the other night that was talking about Jupiter and how it was so unusual because it kind of held some things away from hitting the Earth, and we owe our existence to Jupiter. And they were basically saying that at some point in the way, way distant future, it may spin out of trajectory and hit the Earth and all that. So they're either going to die by the sun exploding or Jupiter hitting us or something. But I'm not
also
too sure.
Die by a meteor hitting us, and that, I don't know. We have had meteors falling on the Earth.
Yeah.
Occasionally.
Jupiter keeps the asteroids in line.
Right. It sweeps them out of
space. That's the thing that keeps a lot of them from hitting Earth.
Just as long as we don't go from our own stupidity.
The asteroids hit Jupiter instead.
Yeah. We'll go one way or another, but I hope we don't go from our own stupidity.
I'm hoping it'll get a few more turns.
Yeah, a few more turns.
I got another song from Walter and another one from Mary Jane.
Okay.
Cool.
Yay.
Mary Jane, you want to go?
Sure, yeah. Yeah, I've become obsessed with crazy words, crazy tune. And that's one of our older songs that we haven't done it for a while.
I like this song a lot.
Yeah, and I found an old booklet that Kevin had put together, and it was for October 1st at the Brewtorium, and the last song in the book was Crazy Words, Crazy Tune. And of course, I had a copy of it that was just like it, so, you know, I didn't really need the book, but that kind of pinpointed it in time when we were learning it. And I think that we did it at the Kick Butt, too. I know that we did two songs. One of them was Constantinople at one point, and I was thinking that we did Crazy.
No, we didn't. We did another one. I can't
Would
remember.
You like to be a fish?
Yeah, maybe that kind of musically sort of song. But I thought that we had done this at the Kick Butt because we performed more than once, but I may have just been thinking of the Brewtorium. That I had the facts to support. At any rate, we liked this was a great fun song, and we liked it. We voted on it for the Brewtorium songs, so, and some of us were there and actually did it, and those who weren't, I think you'll like it. It's kind of a peppy song.
You're 1920s.
Yeah, the 20s. And I don't guarantee to have the exact tune right, but I think I can sing something that goes along with the chords. Okay. Keeps me up. reminds me of that chicken song, you know, you can kind of get obsessed with a silly song, and but there's so much fun involved in practicing it that I just had to do it.
I like this so much better than the chicken song.
Well, good.
Actually, I did that song at the AUS meeting many years ago.
Oh, all right.
I don't remember it. I think it was before my time.
I mean, this was about in 2012 or 13.
Yeah, well before my time.
Oh, wow, yeah.
Paul, when you said the chicken song, was that the one, Roost Behind the Moon?
Yeah, I don't like it.
Okay. There's so many chicken songs, I was wondering.
Honey, those two songs really remind me of Kevin.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yep, they do.
Yeah.
Gear up, Walter. I want to hear this one.
Yeah, I'm getting my kazoo on so I don't embarrass myself.
It's not possible to embarrass yourself in this group.
Most people, when they get their kazoo on, is when they do get embarrassed.
Exactly.
Oh, believe me, I know.
But not Walter. He's
no, 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 no. He's the one person who doesn't embarrass himself with it.
He's the virtuoso of kazoo.
That's right.
That's right.
Okay, here we go. Now you should know this song, The Twist.
Yeah, this one we know.
I don't know why I picked two songs, very similar beat, very similar chords, but they were just two that I like and sung by the same people. All right, here we go. Come on, baby, let's do the twist. Come on, baby, let's do the twist. Take you by a little hand and go like this. Yeah, twist, baby, twist, ooh yeah, just like this. Come on, little miss, and do the twist. My daddy is sleeping, and mama ain't around. Daddy is sleeping, and mama ain't around. We're gonna twist and twist and twist till we have tear the house down. Yeah, baby, twist. Twist, yeah, baby, twist. Ooh, yeah, just like this. Come on, come on, little miss. And do the twist.
Those two came out really close together, as I remember.
Well, here's the story on them, which I found in Wikipedia. Hank Ballard had a group called the Shiners, and they were the group that did, what was the first song I did? It was, oh, Finger Poppin' Time. And they released The Twist, an earlier version of it, which Ballard wrote in 1958, and it was a moderate hit. And then they kind of groomed Chubby Checker as a kind of clean cut guy who could sing the Twist song, and they released that version, and it was like number one for 6 months or something. And so Finger Poppin' Time came out at the same time and was a sort of a big hit, but he never made it the way that Chubby Checker did. But of course we all know what happened, you know, the great monuments of Chubby Checker's career.
I actually saw him in concert.
Really? Wow.
Yeah, but I saw him, it was Chubby Checker and Fats Domino at the Augusta Civic Center in Augusta, Maine in like 1977.
Augusta, wow. Maine of all places, wow.
Yeah. It was funny because like the black population in the town like quadrupled when he and his band got there.
Yeah, I read in that same Wikipedia article that Chubby Checker, of course, is a pseudonym, and it was based totally on, you know, Chubby, Fats.
Checkers.
And Checkers.
Yeah.
Right. Oh, very clever.
Which I guess makes it very appropriate that they were playing together.
Right.
Yeah. That's what I think is funny. Yeah. So how was the concert?
It was great. It was a great concert. I was a teenager. You know, like the only other concert I ever seen was Foghat, which is very different than Chubby Checker. I think I enjoyed Chubby Checker and Fats Domino's better, to tell you the truth.
Yeah.
They were great. So.
Did everybody play all their songs?
One thing we talked about doing, was it last week? Was
yeah. Oh, that's Trails.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
We worked on that a little bit.
I found a copy, but now I don't know where I put it.
I don't have a copy, or I would put it on the screen.
Oh, I'm disappointed, Paul. You could just put it up for everybody.
Yeah, if I had only planned ahead, I could have dug one up and put it on the screen. Does anybody have it on the device they can share a screen from?
What are they going to do?
I don't know how to do that, but I could email it to you real quickly.
Yeah. Okay, that'd work.
Tell us what the chords are, and we might be able to kind of...
Yeah.
Well, I think if Gary puts it up, okay, and then share a screen, then we'd all be able to see it.
Okay, cool.
I just email it to you, Paul.
All right, it'll be here in a second.
I don't know how to get the...
Here it is.
Oh, that was fast. That was a bit easier.
Modern technology.
Yeah, now if we could only use the technology to all sing together.
Oh, right.
That'd be wonderful.
I know.
God,
yes.
So who volunteers to lead it?
We will.
All right, cool. Thank you.
We will. We've been practicing a little bit.
Okay.
Remember to mute.
Thank you.
Okay.
Also, we got to remember to, we always want to change that first to that first day seven.
Oh,
way
yeah.
Too soon,
good,
so
yeah.
We're going to try not to
try
do
not
that.
Try not to do that, okay.
So, we ready?
Yep.
Okay, 1, 2, 3. Happy trails
to you until we meet again. Happy trails. Smiling until then. Who cares about the clouds when we're together? Just sing a song and bring the sunny weather. Happy trails to you.
happy one for you. Happy trails to you until we meet again. Happy trails to you. Keep smiling until then. Who cares about the clouds when we're together? Just sing a song and bring the sunny weather. Happy trails to you till we meet again. Till we meet again.
I'm not sure how that's supposed to end. Anyway.
That's a great song.
Good job.
Wonderful thing.
I didn't know what to do on that song. I didn't have my washboard with me.
Yeah. Well, in the future, you're going to have to bring it.
Right, bring your washboard. Right.
And then you can unmute your... No, I don't know if you can or not.
Yeah, I can't do that, but I was doing this...
Yeah, we need the horse.
Well, you don't know, but Walter and Mimi and Kevin and I used to go over to a nursing facility or a retirement center and play, and that was always the ending song. And we had enough ukuleles. I played the washboard.
Yeah, I was there too.
Yeah, you were there too sometimes. And also Robert, and I was just thinking the other day, what happened to Robert? He stopped coming.
Yeah, I don't know. I need to give him a call.
Yeah.
I've been thinking about sending him an email, but I haven't done it yet.
Yeah, I miss old Robert. He was pretty consistent even on the Zoom meetings for a while.
Yeah.
Maybe he got tired of Zoom. It's easy to get tired of Zoom.
Maybe so.
I don't think he's our
life. Oh, well, I know. But God, what would we do without it right now? It'd be so isolating.
It's really sustaining us.
Right, it is.
Yeah. Yeah, it's a poor substitute, but at least it is a substitute.
Yeah, exactly.
Better than nothing.
And I'll sure be glad when we can get back together.
Oh, yeah. Man.
Otherwise, we'd all be home drinking right now.
Yeah, we would.
What a shame.
Your points for Gary.
Good point there, Gary.
Oh, goodness.
Well, you guys have a good week.
Thank you.
You too. Catch you later.
Okay. Bye-bye, everybody.
Bye. Bye. We'll see you Thursday. Or see your chats Thursday.
Yes.
Oh, right. Yeah, I forgot about
that.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Bye, y'all.